So this performance is one of truth, honesty, and it really comes from the heart. It's not all happy, and it's not all bad. And it's not all we hate the police, and it's not all we hate liberals or whatever. Here's Abby, and she's going to talk to you a little bit about her marriage. Hey y'all. The founder of AmeriTruth, James Walsh, can't be here tonight, but I was fortunate enough to be a student of his at CU Denver, where he teaches history and truth theater. So anyone who signs up for class ends up just getting in front of class and acting, which really, pulls the audience up. Soon after having his class, I decided I wanted to be a part of the troupe after I'd seen some of the shows. We've done shows speaking truth to power in terms of early American labor movements, Colorado history, most recently the untold history. And we did Stories from Our Own Lives, which is pretty much kind of like group therapy, kind of like what happened here. Although, us troopers have known each other a long time before we did Stories from Our Own Lives. Here is like how we got to know each other. This is intimate. I think people feel it's vulnerable to share these stories. We're happy to be here. It's going to be a little bit chaotic as movements are. The reason we are named Romero Group is because of a man named Oscar Romero, who was appointed bishop in El Salvador. He was appointed by what you might call the 1%, but then ended up taking a turn and representing the poor, and was actually assassinated for changing his beliefs. And so we carry his name in honor of his spirit, and he and our founder Jim are here in spirit as well. Okay.
What is this? Hey, come on, man. just a bunch of bodies.
It's like a structure.
What is a structure? What's the legal definition? Are boxes a structure?
It's a box, man.
A structure is whatever I say it is.
Show us the rule book. You can tell me what the legal definition of structure is. We'll take it down. But until then, we're going to build it.
And where is the structure? Are we on the sidewalk? Where is the sidewalk?
The legal definition of structure is whatever I say it is.
There it is.
Why don't you get the commanding officer who can actually show me the rule book, and then we'll talk from there.
Yeah, come on, rule book. Show me the rule book.
Show us the rules.
Yeah, I guess I'll let you know how it goes. I mean, it's not really, it is a meaningful one, but, yeah.
And MoveOn is interested in the just like helping us promote our upcoming occupied courts action. Like they have a huge list of people that they can contact from this like student email. Like we just need to like put you know a little bit of wording together, and they could like use it to promote us. I mean, like I know a lot of people like don't like MoveOn, but I think that we could use it. I mean, like they got infrastructure that can help, so suppose we use it.
Okay, so I think if we're going to send out emails for MoveOn.org, we might as well send them out through Alec, the American Legislative Exchange Council. I mean, why don't we just go ahead and just send out emails through them? I mean, I think maybe we should just put a proposal forward to vote Rashawn for president as a Democratic Party leader. MoveOn is a front group for the Democratic Party. Why don't we have your boy who coughed up $65 billion and fly his 30,000 drones over everybody while they're spying on everyone? They can sprinkle pamphlets on everybody. I should vote for the Democrats. Let's just vote Rashawn for president. I think that we should do, I think we should move motion to vote in Rashawn for president.
Yeah, look, I mean, I say we co-opt the hell and move on. Oh, by the man, we can answer. Speak up.
to co-opt our message, which they've already been doing?
I mean, it's to get the message out there. Like, you want to get the message out there too, right?
Yeah.
So, there's ways available for us to do it. Should we use them? I mean, I just want to say to you, like, what is, like, there's got to be some way to do this. Like, you know that I respect you. I think you respect me, right?
I mean, yeah, I do, but I just think there's other ways to get our message out there.
I mean, there are for sure, but we just, we're both going to move for the same reason, right?
That's true.
We got to respect her. Like, that sort of thing. Like, did you see that woman who walked away and interviewed by Fox News?
Yeah, that was horrible. That made us look really bad.
Yeah, man, that's like, this sort of thing, like, they always get the BS. They always get the bad stuff. Like, why can't they catch anything positive? Like, they're trying to catch something.
I guess I sort of feel where you're coming from. I guess ultimately we just want to see the movement be successful, and we just have different opinions about how we think that that's actually going to happen.
Yeah, well, hey, I mean, I'm sorry for all the bullshit.
I'm sorry you're being great.
Stand here. rather than righteousness, justice, and peace, in order to eliminate the oppression that is going on, greed. God, we just thank you for sustaining this, Lord. And thank you for all the people who are donating to us, Lord, believing that we are carrying their concerns about foreclosures and homelessness and oppression, and wars and prisons and schools being closed, God. God, we just thank you for this opportunity and thank you for strengthening us to go on another day and fight this fight. And the only way we'd be wrong is to not fight this fight. So we just thank you, and I thank you for these brothers and sisters, Lord, who stand out here day and night, being visible in their presence in zero below zero temperature. So I just thank you, and thank you for my brothers and sisters in the Occupy. Amen.
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 Thank you. Thank you so much for bringing us all out this evening.
So I think in March.
issues of capitalism.
That was cool.
all boo-booing when we could be talking about other things, like the march that we have planned for next Tuesday. And I, you know, I don't know. Maybe we do look a little better. Maybe they can take us on the front lines when we're being come at by cops. I don't know. I just feel a little funny now. I feel like we look like babies.
I don't understand. I think the men are being nice to us. You know, maybe it's because you guys aren't being assertive enough. I don't know.
Candace had me. She was totally, basically ignored by most of the people in our group. Probably even some of us women. Who knows? Maybe we're guilty of it too. Who knows? But this can't go on. Everybody has a good idea. And I, for one, don't feel comfortable letting my idea go, because I sure don't want to have happen to me what happened to you.
I want to speak in my mind. In my opinion, I think a lot of the men who women are not necessarily trying to be aggressive of us. I just feel like they have over time through society, through their culture, really documented with these things and that. And you come together and you can work through the issues you fight by a lot. You want to have this special service. It looks like time's up for the Women's Leadership Caucus. So we are going to allow the men and women to come in and have their own caucus for the women.
Okay, come on guys, step up. I think we should use the ball as well. Come on.
Out there that we need to hear. So I'm happy to go on to hear all that stuff.
can say is that, you know, we've been fed up with the bullshit too. We buy into it.
Yep.
And so when one thing is bullshit, I want to be called out. I appreciate it that you pointed out right there.
The one is that
I think it's really important for us as males to be cognizant of those things and call our, you know, our comments out on this. So yeah, I think that's
important. Well, it looks like our time's almost up, guys, but I really think it's been a great building experience for us, and we just need to learn to check ourselves and be aware that this isn't just an internal struggle or an issue. Great job, guys.
I just want to say, like,
talk to both of us.
It wasn't both of us, I'm not okay with it.
I was next, and I mean, like, I think it was messed up too. You know, like, I understand, like, Hancock is shirt for having done what he did, but I don't think it was our place. It was not our thing.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have said that to him.
Challenging everyone's by being here. It's a fucking mess, and we know that.
Yeah, Abby!
Hear the heartbeat.
occupy them or to stay safe. What do you think?
No.
What do you mean no?
No, because if we don't stand up for people leaving, then we would probably have no health care or no education. And then the bank would bankrupt us, and then we would all become homeless and the rich would just become famous and stuff.
Oh, once again, you're probably right.
At hockey.
Yeah.
What about in your classroom?
Yet on the other hand, he was scared of them. That was the first thing. The second thing was I really wanted to go to the second month and 17 celebration of Wall Street's second birthday. And I was very, very scared because it was a night march and all the violence had happened the night so far. So I decided I would take him and surround us with a few people that I had gotten to know at Occupy Denver, and we started marching. And the next thing I know, William's got the megaphone and he's leading chants. Then we get to the Federal Reserve, and anyone who knows me knows how uncomfortable I am speaking in front of people. And he proceeds to give a speech in front of, I don't know, 200 people, telling them how he wants his public education, he wants his college, he wants air. And I thought, okay, this is right. Like this play, it's been an imperfect time. There are some things as a 10-year-old that he's been exposed to that I had to explain that I really didn't want to at the age of 10, but I have. There have been other things that have been phenomenal. There have been some incredible role models for my son. They listen to him. They allow him to speak. He listens to them. And I think through it all, with the heart that my son already has, it has really strengthened him and has given him a voice.
Okay, so this is a story that was brought forward to someone who couldn't be here tonight. It's a really powerful story, and I'm actually going to be playing this individual's brother. We switched genders for no apparent reason, so that I felt really connected to this scene. So here it is. This is for Kyle.
Yeah, I just finally got home from the GA last night. Yeah, it was pretty long, but yeah, I just got back off the bus from Westminster, so yeah, I'm gonna actually get some rest. Talk to you later.
Figure it out.
coming up.
Just don't want them around. They smell, they stink. They're always
they're bothering my employees all the time, always asking for a cigarette, and, you know, just, can I borrow 5 cents, 25 cents?
Well, I'm feeling it. I hear what you're saying. Yeah, we're going to take it.
Thank you.
Can we please have somebody from the Civic Center?
Next door.
Yeah, it's Desiree, please. Can you tell us about Civic Center Park, please?
Denver, we here are talking about compassion. reaching out to the disenfranchised and helping them in their communities, but instead, we are not solving an issue. We are merely sweeping under the rug in the name of the business interests of the city, so that we cannot really solve a problem, but really just create this facade that we're trying to make things different. You, Councilman Nevitt, have completely subverted this entire
voted yet. This is ridiculous. All right? I'm an office.
Mr. Brown. Sorry, that is bad.
This is my time. Email to my constituents. There's fear in the streets. Homeless people are overrunning the city.
What are you all talking about here?
Good.
the shelters, and they've been closing the door on me. This is not enough bed for us. And I can't have my kids up here on the street. For us, this is real. And I want to thank all of you. I want to thank each and every one of you for being up here. I mean, it's okay.
Marginalized my people, Latino and Latina people, pushed out.
attempt out of my district to take away their power. I've seen this council over and over again hit on and push out the most vulnerable in our society. I'm seeing it all over again. I'm ashamed.
Shame.
Oh,
Rise up my love and fall. not going to let him pull up on the side of the street here to give us donations anymore.
I know. I think part of the reason that GA is going so well is because people are just hungry.